Hi, we are discussing new farm law in Rising India. A bit about me. This video, we are focused on this discussion. There is objection to the farm laws, why for new laws are not needed. But a bit about me before we go. I am Praveen Baiskiar. I'm an agriculture and food engineer from IIT Kharagpur. I run farms in Mandsaur, MP. We supply farm fresh food all over India via postal system. And you can save a massive amount of money, up to 50% the market price. Okay, let's go back to the issue we were discussing so that we stay focused. Right, so let's take this part by part. So first part I will take is new law was not enough, could have been done implementing building trust. I know, there are, but actually think this way, this is not really a new law. It's actually return of freedom taken away from farmers from previous ruler. It's, you know, you can call it a new law when you're giving, when you are restricting somebody, right? So now this is actually freeing the farms. If you read the farm, right, law, it's not that it's disallowing something, it's allowing something, you know, which why should it not been allowed to begin with even, right? But obviously previous rulers are rulers, right? Allows, you know, it's not about disallows. Facilitate, again, it's not about not facilitating. You can just not use it if you don't want. You want to pay without money, without taxes, but you can pay with taxes. And deregulates, that means you are not penalized for storing more. If you don't want to store, don't store. Nobody's saying you store, right? Okay, let's come back to you. It's like saying that British used to say, like, Indians are fool and don't deserve freedom. Do you think farmers are fool and cannot handle more freedom? Why do you think farmers' freedom needs to be curtailed or farmers needs to be chained? Farmer owns the food they grow and they should... Why should they be forced? Why should they be forced to sell their produce to few vendors in demeaning and humiliating way? It is their food. They've grown their food. Who are the rulers to put a restriction on what farmer can do with their food? Farmer own the food and they should have right to sell the food to anybody they desire at any price they desire. Why should farmer waste 1 to 3 days to sell the produce at less price? Do you know how difficult it is to sell the food in the mandi? Like, we used to stand, sometimes they have to stand in queue for days, night and day, just to get inside the mandi. And even say, even if there's no queue, the whole day is wasted. You have to wait for your turn. Even if the produce is sold at a very low price, the money is not given till the end of the day. They are like, for their own price, they have gone here, go there, do this. And they even have to pay money to, like, loader, unloader. Plus, they get very less prices. Like, usually what happens is, because any mandi, like chana, right? Chana vendors, they are only like very limited amount of vendors there, like, you know, and they sit together, so they have a cartel, right? They and plus, even not a cartel, it's just about bhaichara, you know, brotherhood. Nobody wants to go against another vendor, a trader, because if some traders bid against another trader, that they, you know, it's not seen in India. The people like to be good, you know. So if somebody is buying, farmers are external party to the mandi. They don't stay in the mandi. Whereas vendor, the trader stay in the mandi. They in and out. They talk to each other. They have food each other. They party with each other. So they have a close connection and with each other. So when bidding happened, they're like pretty much well decided, today I will buy this chana for 10 rupees kilo or 15 rupees kilo. I have sown peas, you know, mutter for 2 rupees per kilo when the market price were well over 40 rupees per kilo. It's a cartel which farmer had no way out. If the vendor decide to buy that day that I will buy this food for 5 rupees per kilo, it's this farmer can just to take away the food, like after 3 days and trolley burning diesel, going to mandi, the cost of taking away the goods from the mandi itself is like 2 to 5 rupees per kilo. So even if they get a price of 2 to 5, at least they will think, oh, I don't have to waste more money to take away the food. So this is the issue when we have, when we restrict farmers to, so now farmers can sell to anybody. We'll see against that. And again, let's see other things. New law will make middleman go, not go away. So, okay, so no middleman are going. So you see saying no middleman may go away. So who's having the issue? Okay, middleman will stay. Yeah, it will stay. So what's the big deal? It is there, they are there and they will continue. Say, as long as we get the price, who cares about it? How? As long as we get the freedom. And here you, so you know, laws are murky thing. Yeah, so things are murky. Yes, things are murky, right? So why you need a restriction? Go first, sort out and find out. Farmers are not guinea pigs or rats to be experimented on. If things are not clear, why you wanting, asking rulers to, why you want to put restriction or chains on farmers? Things are murky, yes. So let farmer do whatever he wants to. Do you think farmers are fool? Anyway, let's see the advantage, few advantages of the law gives. We can sell to anybody. So you can get the preservative, like consumer can get preservative free food. They don't have to buy degraded, harmful food from vendors, because vendors will add preservative. Otherwise, like chana, any most food item needs preservative. Otherwise, and vendors will buy the cheapest preservative, which is very harmful to human. We have to pay less prices, no commissions, no mandi fee, saving money. We incur zero expenses, no more. We can directly sell from farm, no more required to arrange transport mandi. We can charge to customers. Like our program, we give 50% saving to customer, but we charge transport. You can choose to use 5 rupees per kilo transport or 45 rupees per kilo transport, like direct home to delivery. It's upon you, and we charge whole transport upon to customers. So we don't have to pay the transport expenses. We don't have to take the risk. We already covered this point. We'll not cover this guy. And I can do contract farming, right? You can pay me upfront and you can get the desired food you want. Like you need something special, we can grow it for you. If you need farm fresh food, you can pay us and get the food at 50% fees. You can have, this gives you 50%, 1 lakh farm fresh food program saves you 50%. So you can pay upfront to save more money. We even collect subscriber fee, like 100 rupees, we collect, it's just a fee. We sell it at ad hoc, whatever is the rate we want to sell at that time. Or even farm visit, you can visit farm and you can have a better health and we charge farm for visit fee. You can store as much food as you want. You don't have to buy at expensive prices. You can store as much as you buy from us and before preservative and save for the whole year or for 2 years or 10 years. Who cares? We can grow as much grain we want, right? Because storage has restriction has been lifted. We can easily grow 100 times, 10 times more food. Like we are educated farmers, especially we have the technology to grow 10 times more food. But the problem in food industry is, like in the current VS system, if there is no storage, no long-term storage, the food prices drops. And it's not, if you're not allowed by store to stock, nobody can even buy it, and they just, nobody buys it, means the prices just goes down. People can get jobs now, so it's even benefit. Start food business, say chana we sell for 45. How much rupees do you sell in, or you're buying in your city? Sell peanut for 50 rupees, because there's a huge margin. We think it is 20 to 50%. Yeah, people can earn as much as they want. Start delivery business. So if you are in a delivery business or you want to deliver, you can earn a lot of money from us now. Delivery men, you don't. So farmers have a right to sell the food directly to customers, and you can partner with farmers directly, and you can deliver to consumer as per farmer choice or as per consumer choice. Like you can partner with consumer, you can partner with farmers, whomever we like. Delivery men also, like if you don't are a big company, even delivery men can earn a lot of money. Our farm business pay 40 rupees per delivery. And you can do at least 6 delivery per hour and earn up to 50,000 rupees. Huge number of job creation. Like because we are lifted, the restrictions are gone. And we can do freely contract with other business and big business export. The export will rise drastically. That's the reason there's a lot of benefit So basically, the new law, what I see, has huge amount of benefits for everybody. Like, as you can see, there is benefit for everybody. And as you can see, the all the objection which they were raised were not really an objection. Like, none of them, middleman is not harmed. Things are murky, laws are murky, so don't have restrictions. So there's nothing, there's at least, so this whole point is completely invalid. You have to be careful, right? You have to analyze the law carefully. The laws are very simple. There's nothing complicated. Don't imagine things which doesn't exist just because it's not about a protest. Like, okay, people are paid for protesting. I don't know. People are paid or get benefits, like get free foods. But anyway, I will let you with this guy. Please don't take away the freedom from farmers. If you have any question, please comment. If you want to join our program, Farm Fresh Food Program, and take benefit from the new law, or anyway, please subscribe. Or there's a details. Okay, thank you. Catch you later. Bye.